four teenage girls, all under the care of the authorities, all with problem pasts and all with an uncertain future. A 100-year-old yacht and two instructors. Is this a recipe for disaster or redemption? In a brave experiment, they've been sent to sea to sail around the East Anglian coast in restrictive, sparse conditions.
But yeah, I'm under no doubts whatsoever that it'll be tough for them at times.
There would be tears, tempers, and a boiling sea of emotion.
Well, what else?
But for some, it would herald new horizons and change their lives.
It's been the best 5 days of my life. Sing like you want this.
Wisbeach. Four girls from landlocked Bedfordshire are embarking on a 5-day voyage from the Wash around the coasts of Norfolk, Suffolk and Essex.
Oh man,
we just spilled the milk.
Option.
Courtney, Susie, Amy and Nikita, aged 14 to 17. They were chosen by Bedfordshire's Children's Services and Youth Offending Team. On board is youth worker Tara Earnshaw. On shore, senior youth leaders are following the routes in case of problems.
All right, can I see your eyes?
Can't see
you.
Put your hood down.
Let me see your face so that I can remember you visually, because on the deck I'm going to need to see you to talk to you, yeah? What I'm asking you to do is necessary for the safety of the boat.
Duet is a vintage yacht operated by the Essex-based Cirdan Trust, who take young people to sea for life-changing experiences. The skipper is Dawn Franklin. Lucy Isaacs is the mate.
So, what's the one at the front called?
Dawn's rules are not to be broken.
This big lump of wood. See how that moves? Yeah, that moves all the time.
I mean, they're quite a mixed group, really, both in terms of age and their experience. So they're ranging from 14 to 17. And in that range is some of them have had secure unit experience because they've been in trouble with the law. Most of them, I think, have got anger management issues and have either self-harmed or been aggressive to others. And I think, again, that is reflecting their lack of control and frustration. Most of them who've got through that have started now to learn how to behave, that we're just seeing some difference in their behaviour now, but with occasional lapses. So, yeah, they've been in trouble with the police, some of them. Others may be at high risk. They've had a little bit of a skirmish, and we're hoping this experience will get them to think twice, really. And I think, again, that's a big benefit, really, getting them to understand the journey they're on and the path they're taking, that there are alternatives.
The trip won't be easy, living in small, crowded conditions with few home comforts, no shower, TV, just very basic facilities. But the girls are keen to give it a go.
To gain experience, make new friends, to do something that I wouldn't have done before.
Yeah, it's a bit small, but it's good. There's only a few of us anyway, so it's all right.
I went on a boat once in Great Yarmouth, but like that was only sort of a half-hour trip.
I'm trying to stay out of trouble with the old bill and that, and I thought coming here it might help me think of perspective on life and all this and the other.
These young people in particular, majority of them are living in hostels, and they come from families with high deprivation where families can't afford to give them holidays or to take them away or have experiences that other young people might be able to have.
Sutton Bridge opens new horizons for our four young women. None have had an experience quite like this. Duet is an old boat. Apart from electronics and safety gear, she has none of the high-tech paraphernalia of modern yachts.
There are a lot of rules, and I can see that something imminent is going to happen, and it could be very dangerous or detrimental to all of us because we're all on the boat. So if you say, pull that quickly, or do that quickly, or take that now, then they know that you're doing it for that very reason, to keep us all safe. I think when you are at school, and if you're not particularly good at school, or you're not getting on well at school, you're given a lot of rules, but you don't really understand why, because they may not be relevant. It's the boat and the sea that does it.
The first night sees Duet dropping anchor a few miles off Holcombe on the Norfolk coast. It's an uneasy night. The girls sleep lightly and are up at first light. There's a tide to catch.
Against the tide, really, so the quicker we get it done, the quicker we get to the other end.
The sun had risen now and set the fibres
burning. Come on, girls, that's it!
That's it! Fantastic! Energy, I love it.
On the surface, it's calm, but below decks, tensions mount.
Come on, girl. It's the Queen of the Royal.
That's about working together, darling. We've got to. I know everyone's tired. I hate this time of morning. I really hate this time of morning.
We're working together. We're like the slaves, man.
Come on, gang, help me out here. Let's all give
Courtney upstairs.
Courtney, please.
Come on, man.
You go up there, then.
No, more like running around on their bitch, right? Doing it, they want to do it themselves.
It's about working.
I ain't no
dog. They're doing stuff. It's not like people are sitting down yet and telling you, Courtney, you're the only one doing stuff. Everyone's got to do stuff. It's about working together.
They've been doing their bitches.
No. Come on, Courtney, I don't want to argue with you.
The whole point of coming here is to learn how to save us, what they're teaching.
Well, we're not going to learn nothing while sitting down here.
Because she wakes up, she don't like waking up early in that, and she woke up early, and that annoys her a lot, and when people are saying stuff about her and all this and the other, she just completely kicks off, and that, so. To see her calms me down like that, so. So when I feel myself going to kick off, I just, like, if I'm downstairs, I come straight upstairs and like, yeah, I'm calm. It's cool, man.
Because I don't speak to you like that.
I
give you nothing but respect, and that is not on.
I do.
You need to sit down and think about that, because I do.
I ain't thinking about
you. You need to get it, Courtney, because that is
out.
It is not on.
Soon, the sea would change, and so would Susie. Brings things to a head. Two of the girls decide they want to jump ship and head home to Bedfordshire.
Good riddance for a lot of years as well.
Susie, it's just not really our thing.
Apart
from the ups and downs we've had, it's all been fun, but it's just too much.
Too much, I'm fed up with looking at the sea, the river, whatever the hell we're on, I'm fed up with it.
Because you've been here for 2 days, so you have had 2 days, 48 hours worth of experience. Yeah, but you've worked really hard, both of you. Everybody has.
Can I just say, if you've had such a fantastic time and the last 2 days have been really good, can you just express why you're going?
Because we just have, basically.
We're just sick and, you know, miss our families and stuff.
But it's 2 days. It's 2 days.
If you want me to kick off and throw people overboard, Jed, then I'll stay. But if you don't want that to happen, then I've got to go. Simple as.
But I'm telling you, you've let me down. I feel really disappointed.
Yeah, but we're saying
that you're not seeing this through. I mean, I do think, girls, in a lot of ways, in all of your lives and what's happened and what's gone on in the past, yeah, you give up so easily on things. You know, you've got one opportunity here.
You think we gave up
easily? I do think you've given up easily because you've got an option to give this a go for another 2 days. But in the beginning of this, you said that part of what you wanted to do was go into the army,
But if I don't go into the army, I'm going to be a convict for the rest of my life. And what? I don't care what I do anymore. I seriously don't care.
we care, and that's why we've given you this support, and that's why I feel let down.
Oh, terribly sad, very disappointed. Bit of anger as well. You know, I think Tara's put in so much effort. The girls themselves put in effort. They were so excited. I can't quite understand exactly why they've suddenly had this change of heart, really. I suspect there probably is a lot going on in their lives back home. I think they're out of their comfort zone. We talked about all those things before they left and tried to prepare them for the fact they'd be living in a pretty cramped environment, very much on everyone on top of each other. And I guess until they were here having the experience, it wasn't something they could imagine. They haven't got that experience to build on. So I think it has been a bit of a shock to the system, and two of them have adapted and two of them have decided 2 days is enough.
But then there's a twist. One of the girls changes tack and has a change of heart. The lure of the sea brings her back. Coming up, guns, songs and speed. A mass of new experiences gives new ambition and new hope to one of the girls.
I've been in trouble with police, I've been in trouble with law, everything. I've done everything, been there. And if it could help me, I think it'll be able to benefit other young people as well.
In a brave experiment, we followed four teenage girls, all under the care of the authorities and all with problem pasts, on a sailing trip around the East Anglian coast. But this is no pleasure cruise. They've been exposed to the winds, the tides, the sea and life on board a vintage boat in cramped conditions and under a strict regime. On day three, after their first night by land, there was mutiny in the air. Two of the girls decided they'd had enough and wanted to go home. But while waiting for special transport to collect them, one had a last-minute change of heart. Courtney, at 14, the youngest of the quartet, came back on board.
I'm glad I didn't leave, yeah. But part of me still wishes that I did. But it's only, 98% of me says, yeah, it's good, a job I stayed, but 2% is saying I should have gone. I missed my mum and that I ditched my best friend. So that's the 2%. And I feel bad because she left and she's missed out on an awful lot of stuff. I mean, great people, great laugh.
Yeah, it's a bit sad to see one of the crew go because it's like one of the members of the team has gone. But that was the choice she made and that was her decision.
It took a few hours for everyone to get over it, I think. I've certainly spoken to Susie since she went back and I've become aware that there were a number of issues going on in her life that she hadn't opened up and told us about. If she had, we may have been able to sort it. Fact is, she didn't. So she's gone. We were never sure whether that was absolutely the right decision or not. However, by that evening, I think it was very apparent the far less tension, relationships starting to develop. It made a huge difference to the three to be able to relax. Very unfortunately, I think Susie would have got a huge amount out of it. And Courtney, who stayed behind, she didn't even need asking.
In just 3 days, these girls have gone from streetwise urban youth with little motivation to hard-working crew, keen to prove their worth and sail this beautiful boat around the challenging East Anglian coast. Crossing Felixstowe and the busy container ship Seaway, Duedd heads into Harwich.
Hello, Hopeny Pier, it's Dawn.
Where the girls moor her up.
Oh! You got the end, Peter.
They've been invited to a special evening of maritime culture in the form of the high watermark Sea Shanty Singers. So will they shed their street cred and join in before a public audience? Harwich houses offshore and inshore lifeboats. In an effort to reinforce safety at sea and explain just how dangerous the water can be, the lifeboat crew show the girls how to recover someone who's gone in the water.
Anyone that goes to sea really should have some basic training. They must be aware of the dangers that goes on out there. But, you know, things change, and the time and time again we get called out to people who really were not aware of how things can change so quickly.
Without knowing it, the girls have been doing a Royal Yachting Association competent crew course to teach them the basics of seamanship. It's intense and demanding. These girls haven't excelled at school, but here they're proving keen and able students.
These things are really important because they make us go away from the danger.
After 4 days at sea, under the watchful eye and the steady hand of Skipper Dawn and Mate Lucy, they're now capable of putting Duet through her paces. Girls are no angels, but they've faced more hardships and problems in their young lives than many people face in an entire lifetime. They've worked hard and pulled together as a team, to the delight of all those on board. But what of the criticism that giving youth offenders a trip like this is no more than rewarding bad behaviour with a free holiday?
I did hear some years ago that an MP somewhere had said that it was taking young people on sailing holidays. And if that MP would like to step forward and come and have a sailing holiday with us, you may find out that it's not quite the holiday you thought it would be. Doesn't mean that it's bad, but it does mean that it can be very corrective for all sorts of reasons. I think it's a wonderful idea. Other countries have trainees. It's an alternative to forces. It's an extension of a lot of things that young people wouldn't do, which is go to sort of girls' brigade and brownies and scouts. But there's still the discipline and all that sort of thing, the cooking, the cleaning, the way that things have to be done. Otherwise, your environment becomes untenable.
Well, it's a big experiment and a big adventure, I think, for them. I'm hoping that out of this we'll be learning a lot about the way the girls react and what their hopes and aspirations are. But they will themselves, and that's what it's all about, really, about them. I think it's about them achieving something and really feeling a sense of pride in what they've been doing, that they've been able to learn a lot, not just about sailing, but about themselves. They've seen that there are ways forward for them, that they've experienced something that's going to make a difference to their lives.
The voyage ends at West Mersey. The girls are going to start a race organised by the Dabchick Sailing Club.
It's got to be the best part of the trip.
Ha ha ha!
And the final trip ashore is made in style. Many argue trips like this, teaching youngsters how and why to obey the rules and how to work as a team, could give new ambition and new purpose to disaffected youth and also save the taxpayer a fortune. A recent report claims the overall public cost of young offenders in the UK could be as much as £78,000 per offender per year.
I'm sure there are a lot of children and young adults who would benefit hugely from it. As I say, it's providing the sailing experience and getting them away from an environment which that they're not very clever in. So the kind of big, tough individual on the street suddenly, possibly, probably becomes slightly more mellow and seasoned individual on the water.
Ashore at West Mersey, the girls are brought before the High Sheriff of Essex. But this time, a figure of authority isn't criticising them, but praising them and handing them certificates to mark their incredible achievement. The Royal Yachting Association now class these girls as competent crew.
Well done.
We filmed the voyage in the first week of May. 5 months on, and Amy, Courtney and Susie are continuing to learn from the trip and have new goals and new hope.
The best thing I got out of it, I overcame my communicational fears and stuff, so I'm not used to communicating with a load of people at once, and I just done that straight away. So, like, when we was, like, singing on the pier and everything, it was new for me.
It was hard work, but it was good and relaxing.
Nikita is now volunteering with the Cirdan Trust and has a whole new outlook on life.
It helped me. I've been in trouble with police. I've been in trouble with law, everything. I've done everything, been there. And if it could help me, I think it will be able to benefit other young people as well. You want to stay how you are on the boat. So when you go back to land, you just want to stay the way you are. Best 5 days of my life.